Welcome once again to our new part of chapter The Neolithic Revolution. In the first part, we have studied about the periods, Paleolithic period, Mesolithic period and Neolithic period. So now we are moving to the Neolithic Revolution. In it, we have already discussed about the mummy, then after how the human started farming. They started used to keep sheep, goats, cattle. They use camel and donkey for riding. So this already we have studied in the part first. Now we are moving to our part second. So here we are moving with this topic, human settlement down, a new way of life. So what happened next? So the wandering lifestyle of hunting and gathering of early human changed, and they started with the farming. The most important plants were wheat and rice. The farmer needs sunshine and water for their crop. Crop took time to grow, so they had to be protected from animals, birds. When they began to farm, they worked together and lived in the group. They built their huts near water resources. Rivers provided them with the water for farming and also fish for eating. They also learned how to make the things required for farming, tools for tilling the land, basket for gathering the crops, pots for storing the foods. The first time farmer used very simple tools such as sticks, which they thrust into the ground to make holes and shallow channels for thrusting seeds. That means in this para what is said by that human, a new way of life started by the humans. They started with the farming with wheat and rice, and they used to be together. They not live in separately. They used to be together so that they can use the resources very well, and they are also learning. They are also, the first farmer used simple tools first time at the starting. See the history well. In the history well, it is given that one of the important invention of this period was plow. The first plow was probably a broad with divided branch that could be pulled along the ground to turn the soil. Today also we can see them in the modern way, and that was also invented before. First time it was used in Mesopotamia in 4500 BC. Now, archaeologists have also found traces of huts in some places. You can see on this page number 16. In Burjahom, in the present day of Kashmir, they have found mud plastered peat dwelling. Plastered peat dwelling. Actually, what they do, they make the holes in the soil and they used to be lived there. The peats have few steps, charcoal, ash. This suggests that people also lived in open air ground level, probably during the summer month. At that early time also the people are aware and conscious, so they have made the plastered peat dwellings for their summer month. So you can see a picture. Here, this is the picture, a burial peat. limed with lime at Burjahom. That is in Kashmir. This is we are talking about that they have did before. Now we are moving to rearing animals. Rearing animals have numerous advantages. Goats and cow. You also thinking the why these early peoples are started rearing the animals. You know? So why they are rearing them? Because they have the numerous advantages. Goats and cow give the milk. Also animals multiply naturally. They increase in themselves. They killed the animals when the food was required. At the time, early time, when the food was not there, what to eat, then what they do? They can also use it as a food. So they did not have to go for hunting all the time. This meant that people always had meat to eat and milk to drink, as well as fur and skin to make clothes. So what here it is telling, if what the early peoples was doing, they are rearing the animals for what? For whenever they don't have the food, they can hunt them, they can drink the milk, and even they can make the clothes by their skin. Thus the animal provide for many needs of the Neolithic men. So animals, what they did, they have fulfilling various needs of the human beings. That's why the early humans are rearing the animals, started the rearing the animals. Clear? Where the first and herders lived. Now we are coming to new topic. Where the first farmer and herders lived. So archaeologists have been found that evidence of farmers and herders all over the subcontinent. So they are present all over the subcontinent, but there are the few sites where the evidence available, which I am showing to you here. First is Mergra. Here it is, the Mergra is the place in the central India where the evidence of barley and wheat, bones of sheep, cots and kettles are found. Gufkral, here it is one of the site. Here also lentils and wheats are found. Burjahom, we have already discussed this site before. Here wheat, lentils, bones of dogs, cattle, sheep and goats are found. Chirand is also a site. And Halu. So they are the various wheat, green grass, bones of buffalo, ox, millets, pigs. These are found. So these are the evidence found here on these sites. Right? Then during this time, they began to make many diverse kinds of tools in new way. So we are starting with tools and pottery. Farming was difficult with the tools they had. They made tools with edges that were sharp by grinding instead of lengthening. What is this called? Salts. Underline this term. Here the picture of salts is given. You can see the various salts here. Salts means they are the various tools. They are the various tools that were sharpened by grinding instead of planking. That's why they are called salts. You can see here in this page. Okay. Paleolithic tools continued to be made. Tools were also made for reaping and hoeing. Developments of wooden tools were also important during this period. See here in this line after salts. With effective food production, a whole series of craft made their appearance. Pots and the containers were made to suit different needs. Pottery was made by hand and baked in a bonfire. They made vessels to hold grains, bowls for eating and cooking. They knew how to select right clay. They also well aware that how to select right clay, mix it with the correct proportion of the grain and straw to give the desired texture. So they started pottery also, है ना? Now we will talk about the wheels. Have you seen the wheels before? Seen this picture? Yes, this you have already seen the wheel invented by the early men. So this wheel was probably invented around 7000 BCE. Before its invention, logs of wood were used to roll heavy objects. This method was permitted them to move heavy objects more quickly and competently over the long distances. Wheels were first made by slicing the trunk of date palm. It was used in cart for transportation and for the potter's wheels to make better pottery. Later, spinning wheels also come into use. Earliest known use of wheel was in the Mesopotamian civilization. That means the wheels were also used for the transportation as well as for carrying the goods here to there, as well as for pottering also they are using it. So this was used by the early men at that time. So now the life of the people, we don't know about so much about the human being during that period, but historians believe that certain practice that is followed by the present day of tribes were probably followed by the earlier human societies also. We can expect that today's which the tribes was following this tactics that was earlier it was happened, because we don't know much about that period, right? So that was the ending of this chapter. Now the life of tribes. So what we have read, we usually here we have read about the life of the tribes. Usually people of the tribes lives in a small settlement. Most families in the tribe are related to each other. The lands or many other resources are honored by the tribes as a whole. All the people share the products is equal there equally among all the people of the tribe, and strong and clever men became the leader. The tribes have their own custom, tradition, beliefs and gods. The tribal have many means of livelihood. They do farming, herdings along with hunting, gathering. They make basket, tools, pots. The men usually take the animal to grass while the woman was actively involved in farming. They till the land, sow the seed, harvest, thresh, huck and later grind the grains. The children also help. So this was all about the Neolithic revolution. Here the first man we have read about the early men, how they survived, how they started their agriculture, how they are spending their time, what were their means of livelihood, we have studied in this chapter. So now in the next lecture we will do the question answer of it. Okay, read once your chapter again. Thank you.